Let's do it.
You're rocking out with X360 FM. Your favorite radio station.
Rocking all through the streets.
Keep it on lock. It's X in effect. Full circle.
Hey, listen.
Are you ready?
Ready.
For the ride of your life.
Turn this up.
Revolutionary. Remarkable.
That's right.
It's the one and only.
The one and only.
Embodiment Underground Radio with Maureen Guest and the hottest team in radio.
Just and you're listening to
Who's That?
It's X in effect.
Oh yeah.
Full circle.
Do not attempt to adjust your radio. We have taken control. That's right. You are live and in the mix with Maureen Guest on Embodiment Underground Radio. Less talk and more fresh sounds with indie artists of the underground. If you didn't know, now you know. It's Embodiment Underground Radio. Taking control.
Taking control. Taking control.
It's another exclusive. Only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
It's X in effect.
Oh yeah.
Full circle.
The name is just, the gang is us. He's too hot to touch, I guess he's dangerous. Fight for fame for what?
That's
I got
the
things that'll flame your gut. 2, 2, 3, turn your whole squad to angel dust. Finally the earth come around. It's just Junior motherfucker with the summer sounds. Hey, when I'm touring on the road, I keep 100 rounds. Hey, you don't know how it is, the form in 100 towns. I gotta stack up my shot that I feel like I am Big Papa. You put the blame on the streets, I put the blame on your father. We got enough fucking rappers. Where the fuck all these doctors? They thought that COVID was sick. Bitch, I know I'm a problem. Bitch, I know I'm a monster. I want the bread and cheese. You can hold on the pasta, these niggas scared of me. Jason fucking imposter, this how a rapper rap. We ain't know that no one can stop him, no one can top him. I'ma make it happen for bonkers, nigga. Get these bars off walkers. Nigga, trap my rap like a toy. Call that thing Tonka, nigga. Presidential rollie, like I'm fucking Ivanka, nigga. Told you that I'm big, but I can't tell you who shot you niggas. Oh lord, drip down, time for it. Custom black, Concord, just a flex. I'm bored, you can't fuck with my force. I be on my time source. GQ and some drip, something you can't afford. Duh. I know you see me on your radio. This how a rapper rap. I know you hear me on your stereo. GQ, hey, I'ma kill him like Terrio. Hey, I'ma kill him like Terrio. Let's go.
Underground, hottest radio.
Motherfucker, finding it underground. Don't be stupid.
Motherfucker,
finding it underground. Who's tuning on the stereo? Who's tuning on the stereo? Underground, hottest radio.
All right, you guys, you're now locked into the Embodiment Underground Radio. Now, I'm throwing a boomerang at everyone. This is Mahawk, your host of the... Hey, I got a new name, you guys. Mahawk, formerly known as Maureen Guest. So you guys just throw that name, just throw it away. Throw it all the way. Stomp it on the ground, do all of that, okay? So we got a new host on board, on deck. And yes, I have changed my name, and I'm waiting for that intro.
Oh, yeah.
We got to change that.
Change the intro.
We got to change the intro.
Okay.
I'm waiting on Kevin.
Okay.
Kevin, if you're listening, you're taking too long, man. Because I got to have his voice on the show.
All
right. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, you know, I'm super excited with the new me, the new name, and all that. That will be manifested. I'm manifesting. Okay. I'm stepping into my power.
Yeah.
And I'm talking about power because we got a guest here today. And, you know, I told her, I said, look. We're going to have a conversation. You know, I snooped around. I went to YouTube. I checked out the link and just kind of see what we're working with. And what comes to mind is power. Okay? Young power. All right? So we got a lot to discuss. So you guys stay locked in. We're going to have an hour show. I may go over 5 or 10 minutes. You know, sometimes I do 30, but we're going to hold it down to an hour, okay?
We got to put overtime in.
A whole lot of overtime. But look, we have the amazing, and you can find this person, this beautiful young lady. I am Taz, but we're going to call her Taz for right now. You know, that's my last name. I am. Okay, so we got Taz in the building. The song that brought in this show, that is the artist who's with us today, and that is Tammy and Tasha. Did I get that right, Taz?
Tasha and Tammy.
Tasha and Tammy, what did I say? Tammy and Tasha. Tasha, hold on, Tasha and Tammy.
Tasha and Tammy.
Okay, so yeah, I always mess it up. How are you?
I'm good.
You feeling okay?
I'm feeling good.
Hanging out at the radio station, huh?
Yeah.
You know what? We were talking about, what did we say, Tasha and Tammy? Who is Tasha and Tammy Taz? Tell us about, we old folks. We was like, who is Tasha and Tammy?
Tasha and Tammy is like the two most hoodest females ever.
Okay.
Like, if you go to a hood, you'll always find Tasha and Tammy. You know how you got Keisha and Lisa.
And Shaquita.
Shaquita.
Oh.
Monique.
Okay. We were kind of slow on that, right?
Yeah, because I said, who is Tasha and Tammy?
I was like, I don't know who Tasha and Tammy is. I said, but we're going to ask Taz.
All
these daggone teased. I'm getting tongue twisted.
Yeah, she just schooled us on that
one. Yeah. Now, and I may mess this up too, but I'm going to attempt to do so because I'm excited. Okay. Tasha and Tammy is the, hold on, let me do it. Good anthem for ratchet and ghetto little booty girl, females, women.
Yeah.
Right? Did I get that right?
Yeah.
Kind of opposite of Karen.
Yeah, and you know what? I like that because, see, I'm a little booty. And I'm sick and tired of society right about now, you know. So I like that anthem.
Yeah,
so that represents us. So we're going to be repping in the building today because I'm a little booty chick, all right? And so there's nothing wrong with a little booty. So that's power because we can laugh about it and it's funny. But it's really serious because of the fact, and it's a reason why you made that. Because big booties are in, and it seems to be, and I may be giving the wrong reason, but we have this trend that goes on in how we look, body image, and it's no doubt women are much more voluptuous these days. So, you know, a great deal of it is purchased, you know.
Yeah, they want to be made because of how men, you know, really corrupt their mind and stuff. So.
Yeah.
They be like, I got to go get this body. I got to go do this to look like this. But in reality, that don't matter. Like, be natural.
Yeah, and it looks good.
Yeah.
It really looks good. And I'm a trainer, so I'm into physiques and body. And I just think that's, you know, I'm not against it, but it's not me. You know, I'm not for it, but I'm not against it. You know, everyone can march to the beat of their own drum. So when I spoke about power, I was leading up to something because that song had a message. You know, it had a message in a fun way, And one might even associate, if they don't stop and listen to the lyrics, they may think that Taz about to bring out the word WAP on them. But she's really giving a message. She's giving a message that, you know, this is an anthem for the natural females. It may not be over exaggerated, and it's good. You know, we're still beautiful and attractive as such. And I just prefer to have a little compact body. Just feels better, you know. I don't know, you know. But I like that. So that's what I mean as far as you stepping into your power, because, you know, your age group and the millennials, you guys don't play. You guys don't hold your tongue. You're speaking out. You're putting it in your music. You guys are just really out there moving and shaking. And so I just want to commend you for that. I really, really, really do. So it is a fun song. It really, really is. Yeah, yeah. So you vibing it?
Oh, yeah. I let my daughter Monique listen to it.
That's
her. Oh, man. She was like, yeah, that's jamming. She liked that.
Monique, yeah, she'll love you.
She loved it. Yeah. She was like, that's a hidden.
That's Miss Nicki Minaj right there.
She didn't
want to
tell me at first. I was like, yeah, you like it? She said, yeah, it's hidden, Dad. I'm like, you okay?
Yeah, well, you know Miss Nicki Minaj. She was looking like Nicki Minaj last week. I'm like, okay, you know, yeah, yeah. Now, and I, in your bio, some of your, the artists that you look up to is Cardi B, right? Mm-hmm. Was I wrong or right?
Wrong.
Who was it? Let me stop.
It was NBA YoungBoy and Lil' Kim.
Where did I get Cardi B?
No, she said, Nicki Minaj, Cardi B is not. That's like, they was like, why can I say it? Like,
okay,
that's people like, society like,
she, yeah, that's where I got that from.
Everybody desire to look up to, like,
there you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like them, but okay. I look up to NBA YoungBoy and Lil' Kim, cause Lil' Kim got her own swag and like she knows she that, and YoungBoy he got that like I don't care.
Okay, so. Okay. See, I saw her name somewhere. Yeah. Out of speed. So you see, you so detailed. My God, you detail. I'm glad. Yeah, Taz said wrong. You got that wrong. Yes, yes. Now, let me kind of go back a little bit, cause I like that. We're gonna spend that for a while, as long as we have your, you know, your consent. You know, so we'll love to kind of put some fun music out there, and it does have a message. So you guys, when you're listening to music, because I hadn't always been this way, I wouldn't listen to the lyrics. You know, I wouldn't read into it. You know, so it's relevant that you definitely take, you know, the artists, they work hard with the lyrics and put the creativity behind it. So they put a lot of work into it. So I think as the listener, and if you really know music, you will pay attention to the lyrics. So again, we're gonna be spinning that. But let's kind of go take it all the way to the beginning. And I'm not gonna keep trying to guess, because I did read your bio, but I know that you said you realized that you had this talent, and you started around 7, 8 o'clock, yes, or so. Yeah, and not 8 o'clock, at the age of eight, and yes, you rapped and you won a contest. I think you sung, you mm-hmm, Whitney Houston, yes, and you know. So tell me a little bit about that and how you got to where you are now at age. I won't tell everyone, but we know how old you are.
Okay, like I was younger and I used to sing a lot. Like, I was singing and stuff when I got, like, in the fifth grade. They let me play Whitney Houston.
Ooh.
Yeah, in the Black History program, and I sung for them. And I sung at my graduation. And then, like, one day I was just sitting on my cousin's couch, and I just started humming some words and stuff in my head. And I wrote it down on a piece of paper, and I started saying it out loud. I said, oh, my God.
So you nailed it.
Yeah.
You nailed it. Whitney Houston, that's some big shoes to fill. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. And you were how old?
I was in the fifth grade, so I probably was like, I don't even.
It's
don't
another know. Exclusive. Okay. Only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
Also, make a whole lot of dope, but still remain what be floating in Camaros. My little homie see my matrimony, say he want one, but got so many hoes. Look, he don't really know that if he free the pictures, he be living well, but in weak conditions, he been reaching. I be living hella propositions for him, wishing that he listen, but it's hard to pay attention when you on the hoes. My buddy in the club, all religious, he get vicious when it come to getting digits. He gon' holler at the thickest, make her feel like he the richest. Till maybe is a victim, her legs in the air like eucalyptus, but she go home. But everybody leaving unfulfilled when a thrill of the night is built on something fishy and you feel it in your gills. It ain't real, but you keep on swimming out the pond towards the field where you don't belong, and you still ain't healed from the last one that had you in your heels, big stepping towards destruction.
You see, if it's between me and you, brother, I don't think I can lose, brother.
Me.
straight through the heart of me. Breathe, breathe, come on.
Need a breather. Fucking towards the light as my conscience. Breathing. Told you more than others, you a lover, not a fighter. Tryna be a gangster,
should've been a fighter.
Always wonder why the negativity excites you. I'll be damn my next life and a fighter. Tryna find a kid as I reincarnate. That a one that listened to my wisdom, for heaven's sake. Was trying to guide you, God, leave you, got in my way. You in pain, but it hurt to see you die anyway.
Some of those that I don't compare, nunca never. We can do it on the side, como quiera. Pick a place anywhere, tú te llega. Talk to me nice, no sé cualquiera. Yo me tobe, cuando tú entes. Oye, hermano, vamos a cambiar el planeta. Real place from the south, nothing better. Mommy with my dogs, feeling like the good fellas.
It's another exclusive, only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
Tell me what I am if not a real one. Just a little one, shooting the fair one. Traits of greatness running my veins like heroin. Vessel, grand plan in the manifesto. A dreamer's who voice not seen, ancestral. My young soul's hunting your dreams, hunted by goals. I remember struggling, wanting money to show. Suffering, watching mine support a humble abode. Now it's my place to humble the bold.
My, my, my. From niggas to gods. Blessed to be blacker than an African. In a world where they tell me I'm inadequate.
Underground Radio.
No days off. Take no breaks. You in my lane. You in my way. You cross that line. It ain't your day. I lost my mind. I need my spot. Sitting high like a gladiator. Life on the line, cross the state line, straight face when I navigate it. You don't know about the fast life. I got scars from my last fight. And my bloodstream from some old things in my past life. This is not what you wanted. You hunt or be hunted. No turning back, I'm running from it. You better run it. You taste defeat or overcome it. Y'all can't tell me nothing. I spent seven summers running through the jungle. Every day a struggle. People throwing stones and trying to make it stumble. Rolls about the rubble. Tell them they can trouble. So all y'all back up. Back up. I just got knocked down. I still got back up. It's no days off, boy. I take no breaks. I lost my mind.
Say
Underground Radio.
All right, you guys, we are back. We are, this is, I got thrown off that the first time, but it's all good.
Yeah. That's my bad. I tried to get you to pick up that phone call, but you didn't know you was off the air. So,
yeah. Because I didn't announce the lines were open, so it kind of threw me off balance there. But it's okay. We back. This is Mahawk. We got Mundo. Mundo, stepped into the building. What's going on, Mundo?
Nothing much. Always grinding.
Yeah. Just make sure that grinding is you know, got to have a little balance with that too, because they say when you chase it, it's running from you.
That's true.
Yeah. But a little grind hadn't hurt anybody.
No.
Yeah, it don't hurt you. It gets you where you need to go. Just don't chase it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, real quickly, if you're just locking in and you heard those two tracks. It was strong, wasn't it? You know, I like my strong rap, you guys. I like hard hitting rap type songs. I do. I like when it hits hard. Yeah.
The bass.
Yeah, I like that bass. Yeah. Yes, and that passion that they put behind it. I love it. It motivates me. Let's let the listeners know what we just came out of.
That was Toby Ngwiwe. Or Ngwiwe, my bad man.
Ngwiwe.
Ngwiwe, or, you know, featuring Contraband Destruction.
Yes.
And that was a Tedashi Lee Craig, Get Out My Way.
Yeah, I love it. And speaking of hard-hitting rap artists and their creativity that they put out there, I can't get my words out today. What the heck is going on? But look, we got Taz in the building. Taz, you are hard. When I first listened to... I want to say, is it Tammy and Tasha? Tasha and Tammy.
Tasha and Tammy.
What did I put on there? What did I put on the list?
You put Tasha and Tammy.
I did it right. Yeah, that was hard hitting too.
Thank you.
Yeah, and I saw the video. I thought it was cool. I was like, so you're putting the work in. Yeah. I see you out there grinding. And before we even went into our music break, we were talking about how this all started. You know, and we kind of ended on the note around 7 or 8-ish. You know, you wrote this song, you did the Whitney Houston, and it was a success, right?
Yeah. I started posting myself on Instagram, and you know, next thing you know, I met Meek.
Okay.
And you know, we had originally did a song together, but you know, it kind of came to a point where we started working together. Because, you know, how I was working with somebody else who wasn't really no good for me, you know. Mm-hmm. But Meek came in and he really, like, locked in. And he showed me, like, different things, like, that the other people who I trusted, they weren't really trying to get me to where he's getting me.
Okay.
So,
okay.
Yeah, and then ever since then, like, I'm here now.
I love it. You know, and I know Meek, you're a man of little words. And I'm not gonna put you on the spot too much, but because you are, it looks like you are the inspiration, not only just you, but you know, just you know, the Whitney Houston, learning that you had this unprofound talent, and you know, I want to talk about your engagement with Taz, and as a female rap artist, and you know the rap scene, you know the hip hop scene, you know the music scene. What does it entail, or is there a difference between the female artists and the male artists in retrospect to how they're managed, to just the collaborations that are out there? Are there any challenges? You know, I just need to, because there, from my experience, I think it is a difference, because we're not, there's not, everything's not an even level playing field. You know, so what is it as far as from your perspective as the manager, and how do you navigate and move forward with managing Taz, and you know, and where you would like to see her go?
First of all, I tell them to respect yourself and nobody else will. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You know, you don't have to sacrifice your body to get where you're going. You know what I'm saying? I tell her all the time, like, that's not part of the deal. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So if I see, even if she can tell you, if I see something wrong, I call her, hey, you know what I'm saying? That don't put yourself in a bad situation where it's gonna be hard to get out of.
Right.
You know
what
I'm saying? So I spoke with her about life in between music. Like, we had did a song with another artist and it didn't work, and you know, she had her, you know, situation. I let her explain with, you know, kind of put just a little pause in.
Okay.
Her music, but
okay.
You know, in between all that, you know, like I said, we were speaking about life stuff and help, because I got kids.
Mm-hmm.
My kids her age, so I'm gonna tell them the same thing I tell her the same thing I tell them.
Okay.
So, you know, with being a female, you know, I think you have to work harder, because it's on a, if I do this for you, you got to do that for me basis.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But with me, it's not like that. You see what I'm saying?
Okay.
Just try to put you in a good position to do the things that you're capable of. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And don't worry about financial stuff. You know what I'm saying? That's not what the artist should worry about.
Right.
You know what I mean? Your focus is to get out here and work hard and make this good music what the people want to hear.
That's right.
You know what I mean? You ain't got to worry about going to the studio and trying to fly through your song, because it's going to cost you X amount of dollars. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That stress level don't even need to be on you.
Precisely.
You know what I mean? So I tell her, a lot of times people are not going to be on your train until the train start rolling.
Yeah.
Hey,
man, what you talking about?
So mm-hmm. now, you know, her first video, people didn't necessarily, I guess they didn't believe it, so they wasn't showing up. But now, I guarantee your second video, if you would have told them about it, they would have been all flocking. But, you know, you learn how to weed out the bad seeds.
Precisely.
You know what I mean? So, you know, I always tell them, keep the people who ain't no good away from you.
Yeah.
That's bottom line. So she's a great talent. The way that I met her, like I say, and the way that we started working together, I let her explain it to you, but
mm-hmm.
the way we started working together, it was by that I reached out looking for a female artist for another artist that I was working for.
Okay.
And the things didn't work out with me and him, and the things that the person that I reached out to didn't work out with them two. And so, you know, her situation happened. She called me and said she wanted to do music. I said, hey, are you sure you want to talk directly to me? Because wow. I respect people. I don't go around. You know what I mean? So,
there you go.
You know, I reiterated that like 20 times. You know what I mean? Are you sure? Like, you know, talk to the person that I met you through.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, no, I'm talking to you.
Okay.
Are you sure? I said, you want to call? Are you sure? You know what I mean? I said that so many times because I can't step on your toes.
Precisely.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so the other person, yeah, a certain way, but, it, you know, this is a grown woman who made her choice. You know what I mean? She reached out like I was done with music.
Yeah.
And I say that because I have lost so many dollars.
I can imagine.
You know what I mean? And when you, like, it's like throwing money down a well,
mm-hmm.
and you don't get it back, so you get tired of that. You know what I mean? So I got my other business, I got a job, I got everything. So
yeah.
I was done. So really, she encouraged me to start back doing it.
Okay.
And so that's where we are today.
I like it. So you're on a different spectrum now,
yeah.
in the music industry.
Yeah.
And might I add, and I just got to put it out there, you know, I remember you because you are a stand-up person. That's one thing that we actually we saw that firsthand. So you're in good hands. You're good hands, and so that was just intended to be. You know, it's funny how that worked out. And so I like the fact that, you know, you have this male manager and he's not trying to turn you out, because that happens a lot in the music industry. The record labels, they tell you, they dumb you down. You know, they tell you, okay, we want you to be XYZ. You know, they make you to something they want to mold you into. So you got somebody that has your back. And so I think that's simply amazing. Yeah, yeah. So I don't know. I'm flabbergasted by it all. We're gonna play some more of your music also too, and when we come back, you're gonna take it away from me. I want to hear more, you know, because see, fast forward now, here you are, you're collaborating, you have a manager, you know, you're doing interviews, you're doing videos, you're grinding like Mundo over there. who's an artist as well. So that's what y'all do, y'all grind. Yeah, yeah, so let's, we're going to bring it on forward, but real quickly, we're going to go into a really quick music break. And we got some more tasks for you guys. You out there, you like the hard, heavy-hitting ladies? That's because that's my kind of lady. So stay tuned, you guys. You're now listening to the Embodiment Underground Radio. This is Mahawk, your host.
This is Mondo J.
What's up, y'all? This is Silk.
All right, look, stay locked in. We're taking control, folks.
It's another exclusive, only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
I just want to make this clear. I am a believer. But sometimes it gets hard. My name's Dex. Dear God. Dear God. There's a lot of crap about the past, and I don't want to hear it from a human. You made it, so the last person that I'm ever gonna ask. Tell me what's real, tell me what's fake. Why everything about you a debate? What's the point of love? Every time I showed it, I was broken, and it's forced me just to only want to hate. Why is it only one you, but multiple religions? Why does every conversation end in a division? Why does everybody want to tell us how to live, but they won't listen to the same message that they give? Tell me how to feel, tell me what's wrong. I tried to call, pick up the phone. I'm on my own. Everybody says you coming back to man. Why the hell's it taking so long? Why do I hurt? Why is there pain? Why does everything good always have to change? Why does everybody try to profit off another man's work then destroy it just for monetary gain? Tell me, are you black or are you white? I don't even really care, I just really want to know what's right. They've been saying one thing, but I've been looking in the book, and it seems like they've been lying for my whole life. Tell me where I'm going. Is it heaven or hell? I just hope this message greets you well. Had a dream that I was walking with the devil. Don't remember how it feels, but I swear that I remember the smell. Looked me right into my eye and told me everything I wanted could be mine if I gave up and decided to sell. But I said I'd rather die than get mine. Now I'm here, no fear, one man with a story to tell. Dear God, where were you when I needed it? When I f***ed up and repeated it? When they set the bar, I exceeded it. My life is like a book that they've been judging by a cover, but have never took the time to f***ing read this. I remember telling you my goals and my dreams, but you didn't even answer, so I guess you didn't believe in it. I remember sitting with a gun to my head trying to ask you for some help. But I guess you don't believe in it. I don't want religion, I need that spirituality. I don't need people to call a family. I don't want to tell my sins to another sinner just because he's got a robe and he went to some academy. I don't want to read it in the book, I want to hear it from you. Don't want to learn it in my school because they hiding the truth. Don't want to talk about it to another f***ing human being. And that's the only reason that I even sat in this booth. Dear God, how do I take this darkness and turn it into light? How do I believe in a concept where I speak to a man I've never seen with my own two eyes? How do I know that religion wasn't made just to separate the world and create a whole disguise just to keep us in these chains while the rich get richer and the poor pray to you and perpetuate a lie? How do I know this big joke? How can I have faith when there is no hope? How the hell does one man have $100 billion and we still have people on the street that are broke? There's a lot of things I want to talk about and get off my chest. I can't sleep because the devil won't let me rest. I used to know a pastor in a church and I can still hear the screams of the kids he will molest. Dear God! I'm supposed to fear you, but you ain't sent. So maybe it's you who actually fears me. I don't know the answer, I just wanna see it clearly. So many lies and 1,000 different theories. All I wanna know is who really made religion, cause I know it wasn't you, but don't nobody believe me. No more lies, no more death. Bring back King, bring back X. Please, dear God, let their soul rest. Protect who's left and watch their steps. Dear God, dear God. I don't wanna have to ask you again. I just hope that you know that I'm still a believer, so I'll end this all by saying amen.
It's another exclusive, only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
Some learn the game from my mama. See, I used to be a rookie doing shows around the world just to ice my daughter chain. They gon' tell you you can't do it cause you never been a main. But it's crazy, we get life and heal ourselves out through the pain. But they get weak and now they wanna run away. But I'm here to stay. These fellas wanna shine and fly, a girl can do it too. These fellas wanna be a boss, a girl can do it too. We hustle hard like we got some and we're too. A girl can do it too. We hustle hard like we got some and we pretty too. A girl can do anything that the fellas can do. Anything a man can do, we can do it. as I can. If it wasn't for a woman, it could never be a man. Deal with shit up on the daily. What it is, you can't take it. We bleed for 7 days, down to pushing out a baby. Through heartbreak, I keep it strong. Respect myself, I am a lady. Raising kids on my own, I ain't even being shady. Man, it's still crazy. These fellas wanna shine and fly. A girl can do it too. These fellas wanna be a boss. A girl can do it too. We hustle hard like we got some. And we pretty too.
A girl can do anything that the fellas can do.
These fellas wanna shine and fly. A girl can do it too. These fellas wanna be a boss. A girl can do it too. We hustle hard like we got some. And we pretty too.
A girl can do anything.
All right, you guys, that was Girl Power by Taz. Can you cut that mic down just a little bit? You know, my voice carries. Yeah. I like that Girl Power. Oh, yeah. You're singing my song on that one. And you know, she got some vocals in it. Y'all heard Taz?
Oh, yeah, I heard. It's
uh-huh,
tight.
Uh-huh. See, that's what I'm talking about. See, I like lyrically conscious music. It just simply means, what are you talking about? I want to hear the message. Okay, and so a lot, I think a lot of times there is a misunderstanding of lyrically conscious music, you know. And we kind of briefly laughed about it before we got on the airways, even as it relates to profanity. You know, sometimes that's misconstrued too. Just because you're using some profanity doesn't mean it's not lyrically conscious. So I like that Girl Power. So now with the Girl Power, because you're a girl, it's through your experience, you're a woman now. Being a young woman and as a rap artist and growing up, because you had to see some things growing up to even write that song, to even want to even express that song, because there are some females, they're complacent with not realizing that we have power, because they've been kind of conform to think that they're supposed to kind of stand to the back, be seen, not heard, mm-hmm. and only good for certain things in life, right? Yeah, so all females don't feel that way, you know. So you had to experience something, or you know, just navigating through life. What was the aha moment that, you know what, I want to do Girl Power?
It's just like, because like really, you like growing up in this life, you see me doing a lot of things, like mm-hmm. women going, like they driving trucks, they being firefighter, police officer, because it's just like women are strong.
Yes,
we're strong. Like we have kids, we take care of them, we raise them. Like we gotta deal with the emotions. Like a man, he really don't have that connection. Child to say, oh yeah, I stay. A man can easily walk away from his child, yeah. But a woman, she's gonna be like, no, this my baby. Like stay. You see what I'm saying? Like growing up, seeing my mama, like she, no matter what, even though me and my mama really don't click like that, I've always seen her stand strong and do it by herself. And my mama had 8 kids to take care of.
Wow, wow, yeah, and that's so true. And you know, speaking of the strong, you know, and it's, I think it's a wonderful thing. We're multitaskers. I mean, we're just powerful beyond measure. Often, and we're talking about, you know, as far as the differences that we have to actually deal with, whether it be an artist, in radio, whatever it is that you do. I mean, we have these unpleasant experiences. And often the strong woman now is not, well, with some, is considered toxic. It's like toxic masculinity. And it's like, no, it's standing in your power.
Yeah, to men, because men don't really like, if we're being honest, men don't like when women take control.
Yeah.
They don't like that at all.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's like, if you, like, even if you make more money than a man gonna have jealousy.
Yeah.
Over you. Because, like, you supposed to be the woman. You supposed to stand out. I'm supposed to be the king. I'm supposed to be in front. I'm supposed to lead. But, and like, mentally, a woman, she leads.
Oh, yeah.
And a man follows. So.
Absolutely. Oh, yeah. Okay, so you're actually paying attention.
Yeah. So that's kind of like automatic, though, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's automatic. I think it takes a certain type of man to appreciate to strengthen his woman.
Yeah.
Because you strengthen your woman also strengthens the man.
Yeah, and it takes great strength to even have the ability to strengthen someone else. So it doesn't even make you, you know, we're
automatic.
Yeah, we're taught this, it makes you less of a man. Oh, man, yeah. you're going to let a woman, you know, she ain't got you like that. You know, I know, I used to hang around fellas, so I know how they talk. Yeah. Yeah.
That is
true,
though.
Yeah, so you have to have, and that is a tit for tat for both men and women. We complement each other, you know, and we all have different roles. And our stance is that we're just, you know, we're not trying to take away from the man, but we just want to say, hey, you know, we don't want to be in the back or you know, someone with their foot on our neck because we are a female, you know. And so that's what the whole fight is about. Like, hey, we're over here, you know, we bring something to the table more than you can even imagine.
Right.
Right.
And this to Mundo too, man. The way we can look at that too is what kind of woman you got. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You got a righteous woman that's strong. You should be able to recognize it, right?
Oh, you gotta recognize.
You gotta recognize it, and in talking, you know, out there talking to the fellas, sometimes you be like, you know, you have a little conversation like Baze this, Baze that, but then you be like, I don't let my woman tell me what to do.
I'd be like, wait, excuse me.
Let me tell you what I told him though. You ain't know this. I'm telling him. I said, I trust everything my woman tell me. I trust it. So I had to learn the hard way to trust it. I learned to risk and trust what she says.
Yeah. I had to beat him up a couple of times. I had to elbow.
But it's real.
Yeah.
Because you can make a fool out of yourself real quick. And that's what a lot of fellas don't realize. It. You don't need to make no fool out yourself like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's just
sometimes
pride.
Some people get knocked out because I told that fool don't go over there.
Yeah. Don't listen.
Right.
And again, we're not bashing men. We're just, you know, unfortunately, or I guess I want to say fortunately, we can have these conversations, you know, because we all, you know, male, female, you know, when we talk about culture, you know, we can talk about some of the issues at hand and we can talk about some of the things that we would like to really just, you know, acknowledge and be proud of. And that's just one of the issues that we have in our society. So it's not a matter of judging, or I would say judging within righteousness, shall I say. You got people, they talking crap.
You got to know how to understand. That's what I want to say too. You know, your mom, just like your mom, you growing up, your mom telling you some things, you trust in what she's saying. Why you can't go out here and trust a young lady that you met that you give everything to?
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, I ain't talking about monetarily or material. So I'm talking about like spirit, love, heart.
Yeah, all of the
above.
You got
to put it out there.
Yeah, and so you see why I like lyrically conscious music, because we're sitting here having a whole dialogue about this one song, Girl Power. So it allows people to come together and exercise their mental.
And guess what?
And you can civilly have a conversation, and that's why. I'm very selective in the music that I play, and even on the run of the station now. And again, this is an independent artist, listeners, for all those that are listening and the new listeners. We only play independent artists, okay? For various reasons. I do a little bit of mainstream, but I think that there are too many talented artists out here that goes unacknowledged, and actually some of the most talented, because we bow down to, I'm not gonna say we, you guys bow down to, half of them paid their way to the top. Right. They were molded by the label industry, but we have real people, and they struggle, whether it's time, finances, or just struggling with getting the masses to recognize them, because it's real. You know, they're just shoved under the rug. And so we have some hard-hitting tracks on every time we air this show. And these are all independent artists. Now, every blue moon, you may hear a mainstream artist. And it either means that I just got to play it. Or typically, if they're featuring an independent artist. But I am exclusively for the independent artist. Because I just think, you know, and a lot of the mainstream artists, they start off amazing just like you guys, Taz. And, you know, by the time they sign, they like, we're going to have to switch a few things up. You know, I call it being pimped out, okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's just a real deal. You know, and again, I'm just even more excited listening to your music and being in your presence and feeling your energy, and just know that, yeah, you're really standing in your power. You stand up, you know, for what you are and what you represent, and it's just the sky's the limit for you. It really, really is. You know, so I love your stance.
And she's very awesome. You can tell she's thinking about what she's writing, because that first track is just a fun song.
It was a fun song,
And it's to let you know that she can get down wherever she at.
You know,
she can be out there, you know, Ben Hill or
like I say,
Lincoln Home or down in the ATL. And we were talking earlier, you know, we was like talking about Starving Marvin and 7-Eleven. There's a lot of people, they don't remember those things, but
no, they don't.
Those are stores that's
you
gone.
Yeah, that's like, back in the day.
You remember Starving
Marvin?
Yeah, Starving Marvin's in Atlanta, though, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.
Now, you're from East Atlanta.
Yes.
Okay, now we only had didn't the Amigos come out of East Atlanta?
I ain't gonna say East.
Who came out of?
I mean, you got Gucci, you got OJ Juice Man.
I thought the Migos came out of East Atlanta.
No, they're not.
I thought they came out of Decatur.
Who did?
I thought they came out of Decatur, but I think it was
Decatur Taz.
Yeah.
Probably
so.
Yeah.
Oh, Decatur. Oh, I thought they went Gwinnett or something.
No, they were no Gwinnett Mundo.
I'm going by the Grapevine.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
That's gonna keep 1,000.
They came out of Gwinnett.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
They repped Decatur.
Yeah, I'm dead serious.
I thought they came from Decatur.
Okay, all right. Well,
wow.
Hey.
Hey, but that's cool.
Gwinnett ain't Atlanta, though. Yeah.
Gwinnett
ain't Atlanta. That's right. East Atlanta. Is that Atlanta? No, Decatur ain't not Atlanta either.
It's all connected.
You know, that's true, because Grady, you know, if you look at people come from, that's born in Grady, right? Grady served the greater Atlanta area and Decatur.
Yeah,
that was it. So Decatur is Atlanta.
Because
at a point, they join together. They are together.
That don't
you go down Memorial Drive. You going to Decatur?
You take a Chinese that joins a melanated person. They get married. Don't make that melanated person Chinese. They just came together.
You got to get philosophical.
I got to break it down. Decatur ain't Atlanta. Don't get mad at me, Taz.
Decatur is Atlanta because we all got hills. It's connected because it's a straight shot.
It is.
You can go a straight shot too.
But y'all know that song caused a lot of debate.
Yeah, it did though.
And I think people got in their feelings for real, real. I'm serious.
I'm liking that track though. Girl Power is great.
I love it. So you know what? Taz got us having conversation
here. The part that I like the most out of it, mm-hmm. and she said, and they pretty too.
So, you know, we pretty,
you know, you can't, no. Me and Mundo can't say that.
Y'all can't say a word, Okay, we were talking about the experience as on your way to whatever, because I hate to say to the top, because to the top is what you make the top. I'll have a problem if someone says, well, Maureen, you know, what is your aspiration in radio? How far do you want to go? And want to compare me to iHeartRadio, what have you? And, you know, when you reach your level of success, I feel like I'm successful now, you know? And so I'm real careful in, you know, with my words. In your journey and reaching your goals, and we were talking about your surroundings, what kind of feedback are you getting now? What are your challenges? Is there anything that's heavy on your shoulders right about now as an artist? And you're coming out now. I'm assuming because I should have paid attention to details. Tasha and Tammy. Tammy and Tasha. Help me out, Tay.
You was right the first time.
Tasha and Tammy. That's a new release, is correct?
Yes.
Okay. Your video is out.
Mm-hmm.
I loved it. I like the skit, the whole nine yards. What kind of feedback are you getting from the masses? And let's rear it a little bit. Not rear, let's take it forward. And what kind of feedback are you getting from the people that are closest to you?
Okay, I'm gonna keep it real. Like, some of the people that's close to me, they not really supporting it. You see what I'm saying? But you got some people don't even know me, like from across the way or whoever, you know? Like, they supported me, and like, ones that's close to me ain't really too much got nothing to say. It's just like okay. But it's just like, when I like, as I'm, like, going up, like, further and further.
Uh-huh.
That's when they want to hop on my wave or try to, you know, oh, yeah, can we go and do it? No.
Not today or maybe ever. Absolutely.
Not
absolutely.
At all.
And how does that feel?
Ain't gonna lie. Sometimes it made me feel sad.
Because
it's just like, y'all wasn't really messing with me for me. But now that y'all see that I'm, like, trying to go up on this wave, here y'all come, want to ride the wave, and they got me, like, scared to trust anybody, like, that come my way. But I know sometimes you got to let your guard down for, like, to find the right person. You see what I'm saying?
Precisely.
Yeah, because sure. I think I went through 3-4 managers before I met me.
Okay.
And when I met him, it was just like, okay, I'm gonna give it a try. Okay. I'm not gonna be like, because you know, like, thoughts in your head can mess with you, like, oh, I can't trust this person.
Yeah.
I can't do that. Like, and it'll really, like, anxiety mess with you. But then you gotta let your guard down and see what that person about.
Oh yeah.
Like, you will always get that green light or be like, like, they not right. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But with me, I felt comfortable. Like, I felt smooth, safe.
Okay. So your instinct led you in the right direction because you were reluctant. You got to a point of being reluctant to even deal with people. So yeah. I get that. Yeah, I mean, you never know what you may miss out if mm-hmm. you shut the door on everyone. But yeah. I understand that stance. I do understand it. And I think that's a normal reaction, you know, because sometimes I'm sure you probably just gotten really angry about situations too. You know, because it hurts.
Yes.
You know, it's a really bad feeling. So I can relate to it. I'm not an artist. But I think a lot of us can relate to
it. Still in real life, you human. Like, no matter if you rap, dance, sing, all that, we all still human at the end of the day.
We're all aiming for something.
Yeah, we got emotions, feelings, we bleed, everything.
Yeah. Well, this is the first time meeting you, Taz. And you see, we all excited. We sitting here having a whole conversation about girl power.
Right.
I can't get the words out because I'm excited because Taz in the building.
Right.
You know, but you guys make sure you go to Taz's social media. We're going to go to a quick music. No, we're not doing a music break?
Well, I would love to have Taz introduce this next track we're going to put out. It's hers.
Yeah.
It's 40 Special.
40 Special?
Yes, sir.
So what inspired you about 40 Special? What is that song about?
Let's talk about it.
Because, okay, so men, they know how they be like, oh yeah, you would come, you know, off me for $40 or whatever. It's just like they'll just mistreat us and just put us to the bottom. Like, we just need them and stuff like that. So it's just like, I reverse the role.
Okay.
Reverse the role. Like, you gonna do this for me.
I said,
you gotta do this now.
There you go.
And I'm gonna leave you where you stand. If I need you, I'll call you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just like that.
All right.
We gotta spin this one.
Now what's the name of the truck again? What is it?
40 Special.
40, for those who enunciate their words. 40 Special, you guys. Look, stay locked in. You're listening to the Embodiment Underground Radio. If you're just in, shame on you. But we have more. Stay locked in, and we are taking control, folks.
It's another exclusive, only from Embodiment Underground Radio.
Trying to knock me down, and he did my name. Every land will know
Hey, it's Mondo J. Malone, locked in with Embodiment Radio. You already know that we taking control.
All right, you guys, you're now locked into the Embodiment Underground Radio. We're nearing the top of the hour. This is an interview we could have kind of just, you know, I think we can just sit here and have some serious conversations.
Yeah, you know, for just, a couple of hours.
Yeah, now, you know? And each track that we had the honor of being able to share with our listeners, it brought about detailed blog. You know, we were literally able to have a meeting of the minds and talk about it. And, you know, it was, you know, there's a lot of garbage out there. Sometimes it's like, what did we just listen to? You know what I'm saying? You know, and sometimes you'll find yourself dancing to it, the beat is good or whatever, but when you listen to the lyrics, like, no, they didn't say that.
No thought.
Is that what we representing? Yeah. I guess we can have a long conversation about that.
That's
too.
Another one.
You know, but I'd rather involve myself in positive dialogue, and so we're going to stay with that vibe. And, you know, I'm just eager to follow you, okay, and just kind of watch your journey. And just know that you are amazing beyond measure, and you actually exhibit that in your music. You know who you are. You know that you're amazing, and I think we should all know how amazing we are. And if people can really stop and say, you know, you're amazing, they're so amazing that they'll realize that, you know, we gonna support the ones, you know, in the back that you think is close to you. If they just realize they're amazing, they won't have time to even think about, oh, she's going to move ahead, or we're going to be jealous. You know, all the nonsense that runs through our minds. If we can just realize how amazing we are, we won't worry about what other people are or are not doing, and we can kind of come together and be compassionate and support one another. And I think that's just the mindset of the masses, and it's kind of a little bit our fault, and then it's a little bit the construct's fault. You know, we've been kind of conformed to do certain things.
Society fault.
Society, yes. But we have to be smart enough to break through the chains and say, you know what, this is some BS. You know, this is not me, and that's what I get from you. And you're very young. And when I was your age, I wasn't thinking about nothing like that. I was probably doing something crazy around 20. I don't know. It took me a little longer to kind of, you know, I don't know, to see things as clear as you see it at your age. So, again, I give you thumbs up. I give you kudos, high five, and all of the above. Yeah. Let me ask you real quickly, where is it that you see yourself? And I don't want to ask that, Stan, well, how do you see yourself in 5 years? Or, you know, it's like having a job interview, you know, well, why should we hire you? Look at my resume. You know, let's talk about the interview. What is it that you desire, or what is in your mind, your vision, when you're, you know, because this is all manifestation. You know, you're an artist, you're putting creativity out to the masses, you're putting words out to the masses, you know, thoughts, all those things are manifestation. So apparently you have somewhere where you like to see yourself and where you would like to end up. But I wanted to just kind of first cut through the chase. What is your pleasure, independent or mainstream, or a little bit of both?
Independent.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I you know, that's, I like that answer. I be praying when I ask that. I'm like, Lord, they let him say independent. Let him say
right.
Yeah.
She won't hook on.
Yeah. So now, today, and with the new release, and what we've listened to so far, are you pleased where you are? I mean, or are you like, okay, I need to move a little bit quicker?
No, I gotta move at a steady pace. Okay. But I know I can go harder. Well, we can go harder as a team.
Okay, all right.
And we can just keep going. Like, whenever it take off.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, look, you got anything coming up? Anything that, you know, we need to know of? Any more releases? You got some secrets under your belt? What's going on?
I got
on?
A little secret.
You got a little secret. So you can't let that out the bag.
No,
okay, so just stay tuned.
Just stay tuned.
Okay. So how do we follow you? Would we get that little secret sometime soon on social media?
Yes. Y'all get a little sneak peek. My Instagram is IamTaz, and my Twitter is IamTaz.
Okay, and that's double M's and double Z's, you guys.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, YouTube, go check out her videos. You guys, please support the independent artists. I mean, not just because, but they are the most amazing, talented, group of people I've ever known, because I wish I could do what you guys doing. Y'all get tired of looking at me. I'll be all in y'all face. Let me be able to do some music. You know what I mean? You know, seriously. And the reason why I'm just so, you know, intrigued by the art is because, again, you guys, the creativity is what, to me, what makes the world go round. It's how you express yourself. It's how you manifest things. And you put people in certain moods. You know, sometimes you want to cry. You know, sometimes you're on a date, you want to put on some little mooey gooey music. You know, music drives us in every which way. Some make you want to go ballistic. Yeah. You know, when they're talking about some real talk and this truth, and you may be like, you know what, I'm going to go out there and just, you know, so it moves us. And speaking of how music moves us, that takes us to H360 FM, which is the radio station that houses this show, Embodiment Underground Radio. You guys may see our rebrand. We are now not only a global independent radio station, we're not just your favorite radio station, we're also a quantum 432 hertz radio station. Well, that sounds kind of cosmic, right? Sounds like we kind of like the Jetsons or someone like that. There's a reason behind that. And I'm going to give you guys a quick little history for those who are not privy to it. Music has beats, it has frequency, it has energies. We've talked about the label industry. We talked about the dumb down and coercing, you know, with the money, coercing the artists to really become who they're not. They really kind of, I want to say force, if you want to say that, they force you to becoming the artist that you were not before you walked through that door, before you signed that dotted line. And so the frequencies and energy that is generated through our music has a certain hertz. Hertz is a frequency. Most music that we listen to today is 440 hertz, which is the dumbed down. The 440, it gives you the beat, the sound, the frequencies that breaks down your immune system. It has a negative effect on your psyche. It actually incites fear, stress, anxiety, all those things that, you know, we're diagnosed at the doctor's office. But the music, there's a lot going on in our world, and that 440 hertz, it puts us in a negative place, put it that way, and it doesn't have our best interests. Once upon a time, music was at 432 hertz, but they changed it. The construct changed it to 440. You know, it's no different than, you know, one might say it's a conspiracy theory, but it's not. It's actually factual, so I would suggest everyone research music and their frequencies. 432 is the electromagnetic beat of the earth. Any music that you actually put at that frequency, and by the way, that track that we opened up the station with, the show, that's at 432 hertz. We do not play anything through H360 FM unless it is 432 hertz, because our mission is to enlighten and to edify society. We are not trying to compete with mainstream radio. We compete with ourselves, and we want to be for the betterment of society. Entertainment has a negative connotation, and we are not a part of that equation. We feel and we know that we can still be a part of the entertainment industry and not be a part of what is trending and the negative component of entertainment, because entertainment is initially, I don't want to say created, I think it's just something that exists. Entertainment is for the betterment of mankind. Okay, so that's what we stand for as a radio station, a radio show here at Embodiment Underground Radio. This particular show is independent, all 432 hertz music. We do not play. We're going to leave something for the world to talk about, you know. And so we're right there with you, Taz. We too are on a mission, and we're pacing ourselves, but we have our eyes on the prize too. And not just for us, but for us and the rest of the world. So that's what we stand for. Okay, so any of your music that we're airing on the airwaves, hit that frequency. And listeners, do your homework. Don't take it from me. Always research, you know, there's a lot of talking out there. We got YouTube, we have all these people with information. Use your own discernment and educate yourself, okay? I'm just giving you something, an aha moment, and say, you know, I think I want to check that out. And so I like to spread that with the artists. And for any artists out there that are listening, you want to get your music on the airwaves, you want to get in rotation for the runner station, you want to interview, go to our website, you guys. You can find us at ETS360FM, or you can go directly, if you're an independent hip-hop or R&B artist, you can go to our website at embodimentundergroundradio.com, or you can even access our website from ETS360. So we're all linked in to where we're easily accessible. Also, too, we ask that you lock in. We're 24/7. Download your apps. We're on the Alexa skill. We are on the airways, Embodiment Underground Radio. You can find us Monday through Saturday, 6 until 7 o'clock. We have a plethora of different variations of radio shows here at the ETS360 FM family. And so, again, just go to our website, okay? But I'm going to leave on this note. You guys better go follow Taz, okay? Because she's someone to reckon with now. I'm not going to say she's going to be reckoned with. She's someone to reckon with. I like the energy. I like the hard-hitting female rap style.
Yeah, that train moving, man.
Yeah, yeah. And so you're representing. You're representing you're not only representing your age group, you're representing women and men of all ages, you know, because your message is profound and you put it into a fun type setting, you know what I mean? And you're still, you know, you're trending, you know, you got that sound that stands alone, but you're trending to whereas you can, you know, you're with the times, put it that way. And I love your flow. You have a really good flow.
Thank you.
Yes. And then she's so humble when she walk up in here. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I like. That's what I like. Again, real quickly, you guys, you got to follow her one more time. Let the world, because we're 86 plus countries. Okay.
My Instagram is IamTaz and my Twitter is IamTaz. Y'all go check me out.
Check her out, you guys. Let's get that loaded, run to the station, and you guys make sure you lock into the radio station to get a little bit of IamTaz. And it was a pleasure having you, Taz.
Thank y'all for having me.
You're welcome here anytime. Let me know anything we can do. Hey, you know, let us know, okay?
Okay.
Because once you interview with us, you're family. All right?
All right.
Isn't that right, me? Yep, he knows. He knows it. He knows it. Well, look, you guys, we'll be back. Stay locked in Monday through Saturday, 6 until 7. Again, artists, get your music in. Make sure it's radio edited. Don't send me no garbage. I don't want to hear about no WAP, okay? Because you're not going to hear it on ETS360 FM. We're not going to do it. I don't care how strong the beat is and how much. We're not playing the WAP, all right? So that's not us. You have to take it and what? I ain't going to give them no promotion from the mother radio station. Yeah, they'll play it for you. I mean, yeah, we're not doing it. All right, you guys. We love you. Thank you for listening. What are we doing, y'all?
We're
taking control. I'm gonna